Hello my dear students, welcome to the class of 11th English medium. The subject is statistics. Chapter 5, skewness of frequency distribution, brought to you by Vitan sir. In my previous tutorial we studied about the Calpherson's method of calculating skewness and its coefficient. We also started with exercise 5.1 and completed first 4 questions. Now in this tutorial I am going to continue with exercise 5.1 and complete the remaining 3 sums, that is question numbers 5, 6 and 7. And with that I will end my tutorial here. Let us start with question number 5. The following distribution shows amount of annual depreciation of 38 companies. We have to find skewness and coefficient of skewness by Calpherson's method. Let's see. The data given is annual depreciation. Okay, 7, 9, 10, 11 to 20, 21 to 24, 25 to 36. Now, looking at this data, we can obviously see that this is a mixed frequency distribution. The first 3 values are discrete while the remaining 3 values are continuous. So obviously for calculating skewness we need mean and mode, but mode cannot be calculated using regular methods for a mixed frequency distribution, and therefore we can't calculate mode. We will have to calculate median and use that alternative formula of 3 into x bar minus m method for calculation of skewness. Okay, so keep in mind that we are not going to calculate mode, but we are going to calculate median in this sum. So keeping that thing in mind, we will do the regular columns. Now the frequency given is number of companies, that is 2, 3, 4, 7, 12, 10. The total number of companies are 38. It was already mentioned in the question. Now the first thing we need to do is calculate the mid values, that is x. Now for discrete values I will write down the mid values as they are, 7, 9 and 10, but the continuous values I need to add the lower limit and the upper limit and then divide it by 2. So 11 plus 20 divided by 2, 15.5. 21 plus 24 divided by 2, 22.5. 25 plus 36 divided by 2, 30.5. next I will multiply the frequency with these mid values so that I can calculate the mean. 7 2s are 14, 3 9s are 27, 4 10s are 40, 7 15.5, 1 0 8.5, and then 2 70, and then 3 0 5. So when I add up all these values, I get 764.5. Next, I need to calculate fx square. Fx square will help us in calculation of standard deviation. This is a very standard procedure. Find the mid value, calculate fx, then multiply fx with the mid value, you get fx square. So 14 into 7 will be 98, 27 into 9 will be 243, 14 into 10 400, and likewise I get all the values here. Once I am clear with all the values, I will add up all these values and get 17,800.25. Last thing I need to prepare is the cumulative frequency, because I need to calculate median, and for calculating median I need a CF column. So CF will be, first frequency is 2, then add 3, it will be 5, add 4, it will be 9, plus 7, 16, plus 12, 28, plus 10, 38. Okay. So now we have prepared all the necessary columns. We will start with the first calculation, that is mean summation fx upon n, that is 764.5 divided by 38, 20.12 lakh rupees. The annual depreciation is in lakh rupees. So the mean is 20.12 lakh rupees. Next, I need to calculate median, but this time the median is for a mixed frequency distribution, so plus 1 will not be there. I will only use n upon 2 observation. N is 38, so 38 upon 2 is obviously 19th observation. Now if you see from the cumulative frequency column, 19th observation falls under the CF 28, and CF 28 belongs to the class 21 to 24. But you should also remember that these classes are inclusive classes. 11 to 20 and then 21 to 24, that means these are inclusive, and for inclusive classes we need to deduct 0.5 from the lower limit and add 0.5 to the upper limit. So our actual class will be 20.5 to 24.5. Once we are done with that, we have to write down the values. The lower limit is 20.5. The frequency for the class is 12. The cumulative frequency before our CF is 16. And the class length of this class is 4. 21 to 24 is 4. 21, 22, 23, 24. So class length is 4. Now the formula for median is L plus N upon 2 minus CF upon F into C. We will put the values which we have derived here. 20.5 plus 19 minus 16 upon 12 into 4, that is 20.5 plus 3 upon 12 into 4, that is 20.5 plus 1, that is 21.5 lakh rupees. Next, I have to start with the standard deviation. For that, I will use the fx square value here. SD will be summation fx square upon n minus x bar square whole root. Now summation fx square is 17,800.25, n is 38, and x bar is 20.12 whole square and whole root. So the division will be 468.43, while the square will be 404.81, and the subtraction will be 63.62, and the root will be 7.98 lakh rupees. I have to put this value into my skewness formula of 3 into bracket x bar minus m. X bar is 20.12, M is 21.5. So obviously 3 into negative 1.38, which would be negative 4.14 lakh rupees. So naturally the type of skewness here is the negative skewness, because the answer is in negative. Next, I have to calculate coefficient of skewness, which is 3 X bar minus M upon S. So I will just put these values into equation. The S is 7.98. So negative 4.14 upon 7.98 will be negative 0.52. So as you can see from the data, the skewness is negative and it is near to 1 rather than near to 0. So there is a high degree of negative skewness. So from the data, we can say there is a higher degree of negative skewness as the value is near to negative 1 and it is negative. So it is a higher degree of negative skewness. Moving on to question number 6. The monthly consumption of cotton in 1000 bales. Bales is a measurement of cotton for 35 cotton mills is as follows. Using this, find skewness and its coefficient by Carl Pearson's method. Now the data which is given here is cotton consumption in 1000 bales, of course, and number of mills, that is frequency. Now it is given as 0 to 2, 2 to 6, 6 to 12, 12 to 20, 20 to 22 and total. Now from the data you can see here that these are all the classes. All the classes are exclusive, but their class lengths are different. First is 0 to 2, so just 2 class length. Then 2 to 6, so 4 class length. Then 6 to 12 is 6. Then 12 to 20 is 8. And then 20 to 22 is again 2. So the class lengths of all the classes are different. And that means, again, I cannot calculate mode. If the class lengths are different for all the classes, mode cannot be calculated using simple methods. So I am going to calculate median in the place of mode once again. So keep that in mind. We will have to calculate cumulative frequency for that. Now these are the frequencies given in the question. The total are 35 mills, which is already given, mentioned in the statement above. Now I need to calculate the mid value, which is x. So 0 to 2 mid value is 1. Similarly 4, 9, 16, 21. Let me remind you guys, lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2 is the mid value. Next, multiply mid value with the frequency, that is fx. 3 1s are 3, 10 4s are 40, 7 9s are 63, 12 16s are 192, 3 20 1s are 63. And the total of all these values is 361. Next is fx square. Multiply x with fx. 1 3s are 3, 4 40s are 160, 9 63s are 567. 192 into 16 is 3072, 63 into 21 is 1323, and make a total, that is 5125. Last, we have to calculate CF. Don't forget that. First frequency is 3, then add 10, 13, plus 7, 20, plus 12, 32, plus 3, 35. Okay, so when that is settled, let's start with our mean, which is fx upon n, that is 361 upon 35. Answer is 10.31,000 bales. So the average number of cotton consumption per bale is 10.31,000 bales. Next, median, naturally, because it's a continuous data, n upon 2 observations, 35 is the n, so 35 upon 2 is 17.5 observation. Now 17.5, if you see from the CF column, It falls under CF20 and the class year is 6 to 12, which is exclusive already. So the class is 6 to 12. Depending on this class and the frequency and the CF before this class, we will write that lower limit is 6, frequency is 7, CF before our class is 13, and class length is 6 to 12, so 6. The formula is L plus N upon 2 minus CF upon F into C. So put the values there. 6 plus 17.5 minus 13 upon 7 into 6. When you solve this, you get 6 plus 4.5 upon 7 into 6. So 4.5 into 6 upon 7 is 3.86. Add 6 in there, you will get 9.86,000 bells. Now just take the FX square value and let's calculate standard deviation. The standard deviation is standard formula summation fx square upon n minus x bar square. So put the value 5125 upon 35 minus 10.31 square. So the division is 146.43 and the square is 106.2961. Simplification 40.13 root, which is 6.33,000 bells. Let's put the value of mean and median in the skewness formula. 3 into 10.31 minus 9.86, which is 3 into 0.45, which is 1.35,000 bells. Because it's a skewness, we have to show the unit of measurement. In coefficient of skewness, we will not show that. So let's put this skewness value in our J formula, which is 3 into x bar minus m upon s. Now 3 into x bar minus m, we have already calculated, which is skewness 1.35. Standard deviation is 6.33, so the coefficient of skewness is 0.21. As you can see from the data, we have a lower degree of positive skewness because the data is near to zero and it is positive. So I hope you guys are getting how we calculate this Karl-Pearson's method of skewness and coefficient. Let's do one last sum and wrap up this video. Seventh one. The temperature at a tourist place for 60 days during the year 2014 is as follows. We have to find skewness and its coefficient using Karl-Pearson's method. Okay. So temperature is in degree Celsius, which is negative 3 to negative 1. Okay. It's a negative degree. It is possible. Negative 1 to positive 5, 5 to 11, 11 to 19, 19 to 23, 23 to 27 and total. Again, by looking at the data, we are sure that the class lengths are different. Okay, the difference between all the classes is different values. They are not equal and therefore we can't calculate more using simple methods. And once again, we will be calculating the median for this data rather than calculating the mode. Now the frequency given is number of days, which is 4, 14, 20, 14, 5, 3 and the total is 60. Next, we have to calculate mid values, of course. So negative 3 plus negative 1 divided by 2 is negative 2. Negative 1 plus 5 divided by 2 is 2. 5 plus 11 divided by 2 is 8 and 15 and 21 and 25. So these are your mid values. Next, you multiply these mid values with the frequencies, that is fx. 4 into negative 2 is negative 8. 14 into 2 is 28. 28 8 is 160. 14 15 is 210 and so on. While making total, remember that the first value is negative 8, so it will be subtracted from the remaining values and your answer will be 570. Next column will be the multiplication of fx with x to calculate fx square. 8 to the 16, 28 to the 56, 168 to the 1280 and 3150, 2205 and 1875. When you make a total of all these values, you get 8582. Okay, so last will be the CF column. CF is the gradual total of frequencies, that is 4 plus 14, 18 plus 20, 38 plus 14, 52 plus 5, 57 and plus 3, 60. Once all the columns are settled, we have to start by calculating mean here. The mean is 570 upon 60, which is 9.5 degrees Celsius. Median is of course n upon 2 observation, n is 60, so n upon 2, 60 upon 2 is 30 observation. When you see the CF column, 30 observation falls under the CF 38, which is in the class 5 to 11. Now all these classes are already exclusive, so no adding or subtracting 0.5 from that. The lower limit for the class is 5, the frequency is 20, the CF before this class is 18 and the class length for this class is 6. So I will write down the formula for median and then put the value 5 plus 30 minus 18 upon 12 into 6, which is 12 into 6 upon 20, which is 5 plus 3.6, that is 8.6 degrees Celsius. Let's put the values in the standard deviation formula, that is summation fx square upon n minus x bar square whole root. The fx square is 8582 upon 60 minus x bar, that is 9.5 square. Division is 143.033, the square is 90.25, the difference is 52783, root is 7.27 degrees Celsius. Let's put mean and median in the skewness formula, that is 9.5 minus 8.6. 0.9 into 3, that is 2.7 degrees Celsius. We will put these two values, the standard deviation and skewness values, into the coefficient of skewness. So 2.7 upon 7.27, which is 0.37. So the statement will be, from the data we can say that there is a lower degree of positive skewness as the value is near to zero and positive. So with this, I end my today's tutorial. We have completed Karl Pearson's method and the exercise 5.1. In my next tutorial, I will start with the Bowles method and we will start with the exercise 5.2. And because it is not that long an exercise, we may be able to complete that exercise in the same video. Thank you very much for watching my video like this if you have liked it. Subscribe my channel if you have not and keep on watching them. Thank you. Welcome students to With Answers Anekant Academy. That's a better way to success for you. I am Vitan Vora and I teach accountancy, statistics and social science. You can contact me on my cell number 9194263-10184. Please give a sub to my channel and also check out my other video playlist which you can see on the screen. Thank you and I will see you in the next video.